food is about a very important journey, and somebody who lives in a foreign soil and works there. So your food not only represents just the cuisine or the menus, it becomes very much an expression of culture. So anything you do, it reflects the culture, it impacts the culture, it impacts everything around the culture. So shuru se hi mujhe lag raha tha ki agar aap cuisine apni leke and you want to build an empire based on food, it cannot be just a product of food. It has to be a subtotal of the culture of the country. And this was a daily evolution of understanding that I need the right equation for Indian food, and I'm not going to settle for anything less. When you're working with these European or American chefs, the pride they have in their culture and cuisine, it's unwavering. Pride was, sometimes we lack pride and we move towards them, that they are superior, their cooking is superior. It is not. It is not. Indian food is much more complex, more diversified. It has more, much more to offer to the world than just the templated menus what people see in Indian restaurants. You should be able to put, if you're putting culture forward, which is your first question, you should be able to communicate the culture. You know, not the hardest part was not the food cookbooks, the big books, the children's books. The hardest part was doing fiction. Fiction was like the hardest part, and I feel that I'm so proud that this is one of my greatest works in my life. And we started, I took on to the Twitter and I asked people that please go and check into your neighborhoods if you have any orphanages, old age homes, or leprosy centers where people need any dry ration, and if you can email to us. And we did not stop since then, and we crossed 42 million a few hours ago. It was a big commitment of 2 million meals. So 42 million meals we've crossed, which is a big number in 6 months. I did not know anything much about America or England for that matter. I was happy there. I had a staff of more than 100 people in Lawrence Garden. I have a turnover in crores, and I was very happy. But the government, one day, some officials came and they broke my banquets, and it broke my heart. I wasn't that strong to take that blow very easily. And what happened later was that I was getting into a very different mode, because I had built that place with my mom and grandmom from scratch. And that night, my brother told me that maybe America will find place for me. And I came to America following this Jonathan Livingston sequel. That crazy I can. And then 2008, the economy collapse was happening. There was another building coming behind Purnima. They knocked us down. It became the back road of this big tower of Daily News. And everything began to collapse like dominoes. Everything collapsed. All the caterings cancelled within a matter of a few weeks. And when the Purnima closed, I met Dalai Lama, His Holiness, and I went to Himalayas just to find my center again, because I'd failed so badly. It was unbelievable how badly. So when I came back, my focus was not money, not anything. I'd stopped doing all my work, put everything on hold, and we only focused on a restaurant which had the caliber of a Michelin star. And I remember it was an important phase of my life to highlight people with resilience. You're going to see some of my works in the world of documentaries next year. Starting this year, I'm going to sit quiet on that. But we finished some of the works highlighting some of the Indians whose resilience is so sacred, and it has to be celebrated worldwide. We're doing that. One more restaurant process, which, inshallah, everything has been made. And yes, we have two movies in the pipeline, and we have three documentaries which have to be finished. Any artist who's trying to rise against all the odds, first thing I'll always tell them, please read your contracts carefully. Please read them carefully. When a great opportunity is going to come to your way, it will come to your way. It's great to have predators. You only throw stones to the tree which has fruits. but you've got to be very careful. The markets are changing. They need to have the right contracts to move forward. Wait for it. Do not rush it. Wait for it. And do not stop working hard. There is no substitute for working hard. And do not be a clone of somebody else. Don't be. Be yourself. Do anything you wish to do. See, some of the Indian chefs have acquired such global presence in the world because they were not being templated. Be yourself. Do not stop research. If anything inspires you, run after this. And don't stop learning. Constantly, you have to read, you have to write, you have to constantly document what your journey is. But do not stop working hard. There is no substitute.